Me with the guys from Comeback. Yeah, the Comeback Kid. Fuck, I thought I was Figure Four for a second. No. Alright, how'd the band start?
Basically, I've been an old friend of Andrew's for quite a while, and we were kicking around the idea of throwing a band together.
Okay.
Something a little different from Figure Four, not as heavy, a little more straight up. So we started playing around with it, and as time went on, it became a little more serious. So
where'd the name come from?
Basically, we went through a bunch of names, like Shoot to Kill.
I came up with a million good names.
But anyways, I was looking through a newspaper on the front, and it was when Mary Lemieux just comes making his comeback.
Yeah,
it was
like,
Mary Lemieux, Comeback Kid. I was like, how about Comeback Kid? And we all agreed on it, so
okay.
Rest is history.
Okay. Yeah. And you guys put all the songs from the demo on full length. Like, why that?
Because, man, I couldn't write any more songs.
This guy's a machine. He writes all the songs.
When we did the demo, we had it in mind that we were gonna, we just kind of quickly did it in like a weekend.
Okay.
And we had it in mind that we wanted to do all those songs, re-record them.
Okay,
full length.
Right.
So, like, we just put six, seven extra songs on there.
Okay.
And re-recorded them and made them like sound slick.
Right. Okay.
More slick than the demos.
Yeah, they were good songs. We didn't want to throw them away. Like, we did a good job on the demo, but there's little things that we knew we could tweak on them and make them a lot better. So.
Okay. Okay.
They're too good to throw away.
Right,
I think,
right. Yeah.
Just a demo.
Really good songs. Yeah, and the songs were written like in 2000. Like, they recorded in December 2001.
Yeah.
So, like, any difference between new songs and old songs?
He writes most of the music, so okay. Yeah, we sort of kind of progress a little more.
I think every song's kind of different though. Like, you know, we have some more melodic kind of songs.
Yeah.
Well, this thing's going like. Ooh, ooh. We have some more like melodic kind of songs, some super fast songs, some heavier songs. Uh-huh. Like, there was one song, like the last song on the record, I was actually gonna be a Figure Four song.
Okay.
But I didn't think it was, you know, didn't quite have, like, it was, I thought it was super Figure Four, Comeback Kid there.
Okay.
I was writing it for Figure Four, but I was just like,
Well, and vice versa, he's brought in songs to us that we were like, sounds like a Figure Four song. He's like, you know what? I'll use it for Figure Four then, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Makes a match.
But do you find a problem, like, since you write songs for both bands, like, you know, trying to, like, you know, write certain stuff on one and not on the other? Or is it, how's that work, you know? Like, do you find, you know, that made the Comeback Kid start on style more like Figure Four, or Figure Four starting to, you know, turn more towards Comeback Kid?
I think you could totally see the similarities, you know?
Okay.
But with Figure Four, I can't do, like, these melodic things with the high notes and everything.
Okay.
I can, like, sometimes, but you just can't really do lots of stuff that Comeback Kid does, and that's kind of a different kind of outlet that I have to do that. And then with Figure Four, you can't always have, or with Comeback Kid, you can't always have the chugga-chugga
heavy stuff, right.
Super heavy, like.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Cool.
But we try to mix it up with Comeback Kid.
Okay.
We try to have heavy stuff and have fast stuff, melodic stuff.
Okay. All right. And you guys are signed Face Down. So how'd that come about? Like, do you think maybe it's like easier for Comeback Kid because, you know, Figure Four is sort of known?
Definitely. Well,
definitely.
So we're good friends with. I was good friends with Jason.
Okay.
At Face Down, and he had heard us before, and
he basically saw us. He saw us live back in the summer, but we didn't really wow him back then because we were still getting our stuff together.
Scott's got the lyrics. You just sing, you know, you just go like, whoa, 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 whoa.
Yeah, we didn't have our stuff quite together at that point, and he just got back from Figure Four, so we had no time to practice, so it was kind of sketchy, but
And
then we did cut the demo, and he sent it out. He liked what he heard, so he wanted to check it out. So.
Okay.
But I just knew that he's really honest, and he works his label well, so we thought that it would be good to.
Right. But do you think being on Face Down, you guys might, you know, as a like negative point, be pigeonholed a certain type of band?
That definitely was something we were contemplating as a choice, because Comeback Kid, more so different than Figure Four. Mm-hmm. Another thing that is that we don't really sort of set out with any kind of agenda, any religious agenda. Mm-hmm. Like, we are all Christians, but we don't really set out with to put that out on the. I mean, we are all Christians, so therefore it comes out through the music and like through the lyrics, but it's not really in your face. And there, some kids I know, like Face Down Records, right away they'll turn their nose up to it and not even give us a chance. But for a lot of kids, have been given a chance. So at first, what we thought might have been a negative has turned out to be a positive. So it's been totally cool.
I mean, like, I don't know what the problem is. Like nowadays, you know, like, it seems like back in the days, you know, like even Madball, you know, was talking about God, like, you know, praising God, you know, everything. So, like, I don't know what the problem is. Like, now, it seems like, you know, it's like everyone has this thing against, you know, Christians, and, you know, with flame resistance and everything. It's like, who cares, you know?
Yeah, like a band like Shelter can come out and people were all cool with that, but then a Christian band comes out and all of a sudden it's like the worst thing. And I don't know, I mean, you gotta expect that. There's, you know, you can't please everyone, so.
Yeah. We write lyrics about, like, real things, you know, that, like, me or you could relate to.
Right.
It doesn't, like, you know, you don't have to subscribe to any kind of religious
right.
thing that, like, I think the lyrics we write are, like, for everybody. It's not
right.
really a one, mm-hmm. there's not really one thing, one type of group that's gonna get something out of it. It's
right.
like, we're, you know, we just write about real things, like, we're just super honest with our mm-hmm. lyrics, and so we just try to write about our struggles and what we, you know, everyone goes through, like, lots of the similar issues in life.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
So,
day-to-day stuff.
Yeah. Alright, and what's the cover art for the new album? Like, what is it supposed to mean? You have this guy coming out of, like, some kind of room or something, he has his heart ripped out or something.
Yeah, basically, we, they kind of put that in my hands to do the art, to gather up the
okay.
artwork, so,
okay.
I'd seen stuff that Mike Bukowski had done before, and I really liked it, so I wanted something that was cartoonish for the cover, so we kind of, I kind of gave him the lyrics and the ideas of what we were doing, and just kind of let him play with it, and we went through a bunch of different ideas, and basically this, if you kind of want to look at it as symbolism, like, not to come off too cheesy about it, but I mean, the room, he's kind of moving forward, and it's like a struggle forward, come
okay.
from, like, maybe past mistakes or past struggles, whatever it is, and you can interpret it however you like, but it's like he's carrying his heart, like clenching his heart, you know, and like he's kind of, it kind of symbolizes the struggle forward, you know, that you have to go through, and his heart's all broken on the back.
Oh,
if you
okay,
see
I
that,
see.
But
yeah,
you know, kind of the struggle forward, you know, to keep moving on and keep your chin up,
beating up hard. Like everyone, you know, goes through like different things, like
right.
I said, and there's so many things that like get at you,
mm-hmm.
Inside and like. Or like, however, you know, and so everyone kind of goes through these things, and oh, someone wants to get in the bathroom. But it's like, lots of our lyrics are
uh-huh.
about like, not like living in the past, not
yeah.
just like living in yesterday, but
uh-huh.
like moving forward and turning it around, because you can always turn around a situation and for the better, you know. You can
yeah,
like,
for sure,
you don't
yeah.
have, you don't have to like wallow in your, you know, you don't have
your
to,
misery.
Yeah, well, in your misery, so.
Yeah.
Everyone struggles, you know, it's like, that's something we can all relate to, you know, whether you subscribe to a faith or not.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone has day-to-day struggles,
yeah.
you know? So, that's pretty much the kind of stuff we tackle, and that's sort of how the artwork kind of coincided with that, so.
Okay, great. All right, cool, that's it.
Cool,
yeah.
Thanks a lot.
All right, man.
Montreal. I personally grew up here, so it was one of the places I wanted to play really bad. It was super stoked to be out here. But they definitely sent it from me, man. You guys so for that.
Okay, from Winnipeg, a bunch of Ottawa, a bunch of here in Montreal,
around.
Especially my man Brett. Go get some merch from him later.
My man Chicomak over here. Thanks a lot to Dave also for putting on the show. It's a big help for us. Give it up for Kaylee.
Yeah.
He's a great guy. Anyway, Chinese out there. Yeah. Alright, this is another new song.
Yeah.
around in a circle. Last one's on our new record. Help us out if you know the lyrics, both of them are on the internet. So if you have your time to get along, help us out. This song's called Step Ahead.
Thanks everyone for coming out. You guys have an awesome scene here. Don't say that slip, right?